Hi, this is Stephanie with Imbue, and Imbue stands for Empowerment and Beauty. And I'm gonna get ready and talk to you about something that I've been thinking about. So, lately I was reminded of one of the most important things that I was doing every morning that I had kind of forgotten about because it had become a habit, but I broke the habit. And so then it was glaringly obvious why I really needed this habit in my life, and that is to avoid my cell phone for the first hour of the day. And let me position my mirror here. And I first realized how important this was about a year and a half ago. I had gone for a run and I was super tired. I had already been to the gym once that day. I don't know why I felt like I needed to go for a run too. But I did, and wasn't paying attention, and tripped over an uneven piece of the sidewalk, and fell and smacked my head on the ground, and got a concussion. And the 6 weeks following that are super fuzzy. I don't remember a lot of it. But one of the things that you do to heal from a concussion is you limit the amount of stimulation that happens for your brain. So you don't look at TV screens, you don't look at cell phones, you literally close your eyes and try to stay in a dark room, and they tell you to not be stressed. And as a business owner, I was like, okay, I will work on that. And the peace that I felt, though, without all of those distractions and without checking notifications was really profound. And I don't think that's just because my brain was healing from a concussion. And so I started to pay attention, you know, as I healed and from there on out, to something that I had discovered during that time, and that was the balance between input and output. Because the main difference was that my brain wasn't being bombarded with input, with notifications and advertising and text messages or people trying to reach me. And when that happened, it allowed my brain to heal because I wasn't being distracted, I wasn't using my limited brain power to respond to notifications and things like that. And thinking about it afterwards, I was like, wow, this is something that not just people with concussions need, but all of us need. We're so distracted and bombarded all the time, and I think it's easy to forget about that mental exhaustion that can come from working or just living in the world that we live in today. And so having that first part of your morning, and even if you can only do it for the first 30 minutes, it can be super powerful to think about what your output is first. And what I mean by that is, what are the thoughts that you're generating all on your own? Where are you at? How does your body feel? And checking in with all of those things before you start dealing with all of the input in your brain. And this goes deeper too into how your brain works, because we are constantly reacting to our environment. And when we're put into a reactive state, our brain moves in the same neural pathways over and over. So like you receive the same stimulus and then the same thing happens in your brain. And pretty soon, the patterns and your thought patterns and your life becomes pretty predictable and the same. And so paying attention to what's going on in your brain, in your mind, and in your body before you start getting that external input can help you start your day from a place of feeling more empowered and in control. If you're gonna, like, one of my favorite things to do is to wait to check my email until like noon or after. And I know that a lot of people in office jobs probably can't do that. But it's been super powerful for me because when I start my day just going out and getting the tasks done, even if it is on my computer, before I start responding to all these people in my inbox, I get so much more done because when you wake up in the morning, you have this fresh store of energy. And once that's gone, your brain kind of feels fried. I know that we've all had that happen where you, like there are some days where you're on your computer and you didn't focus on the tasks that needed to be done right away. And then by the end of the day, you're like, I'm so fried. I can't even focus on this right now. I'm gonna have to push it till tomorrow. Or even worse, you try to kind of push through the task later on in the day when you're not as clear. And it ends up being something that you have to make corrections on, or the project ends up taking so much longer than it could have if you had focused on it with your fresh brain power. So it's so important to protect those precious minutes in the morning, and you can kind of see what the right balance is for you. I've found that certain days I need a couple of hours to just proactively work rather than reactively. So I will go and put my phone in another room and only work on the tasks that I need to get done for a couple of hours. Whatever way that you can try to minimize the amount of input or minimize the different avenues that the input comes in, that can be really helpful. So, you know, being able to be communicated through your cell phone and your computer and getting notifications through Twitter and Instagram and Facebook all at the same time, like each of those things is vying for your attention. So if you can try to reduce it down to just a couple, or even better, just one, I've found that I get so much more done during the day because I'm having less avenues of input pulling away my attention. So that was the thing I was thinking about for today. Thanks for getting ready with me, and I will see you next time.